okay, this has something to do with the new update. One of the updates was about added device indicator switch. Indicators not disturbed. I literally asked them on their social media. So the light indicator can interfere with the performance of other equipment. The light, I'm like, okay, that's the key word, the light. So it's the LED lights. You can turn them off, turn off the LED. So let's test that, shall we? I'm gonna shut them off on the, I have not tried this. I'm assuming this is going to work. The scope cam, I'm gonna zoom in. As you see, the one that's pointing to us right now is the S30. Let's try it. So it's supposed to turn off the LED lights so that it won't interfere with other stuff. That's my understanding. Those LED lights should come off. We're gonna test it. Anything can happen, we're live. So we're just gonna test it. We're gonna do it. We're gonna do it. There might be a few seconds delay just because of the scope cam. You know, it's online and stuff to it. There might be a delay. There might be a delay. Oh! Okay, we got it. It worked. I don't need to be so dramatic, but exciting that this works. Woo! Stealth mode. Stealth mode activated, yes. So a lot of people were asking for this because, you know, to me it didn't matter because the lights were red and red light is okay, right? Like it doesn't hurt anything. But then again, now I guess there's also that yellow light if you're an alt azimuth, and then if you're an EQ, there's the green one. So I don't know, but Seestar said in a forum also that the reason why they wanted to keep those on, I think they weren't even planning to do this, but I guess a lot of people were asking for this feature because you don't want to trip and fall over your Seestar. I wouldn't. I have plenty of light pollution out there. I'll never trip and fall over the Seestar if, or, you know, walk to it and not see it because those little lights turn off. Like, but I get it. If people live in super dark skies away from the city, I can barely see my hand in front of me. So totally get it if Seestar was like, weren't gonna do this, but I guess because people are asking. Light indicator switch, here you go, you're welcome. So let's do it again, let's do it again. If you blink, you'll miss it. It works. Indicators not disturbed. Boom. You see that? You see the S30? It works. It says it only does it during observation mode, so you have to be, I guess, in stargazing. You have to be actually actively shooting something for that to work, I guess, which makes sense. Are you ready to protect your Seestar? Well, place your orders now for these covers. They are going wild. Navy Stripe is almost out of stock. As a matter of fact, by the time you maybe watch this video, they might be gone. I think there's only about two or three left. Remember, these are both for your S30 and for your S50. And this is for in between your sessions, right? When you bring it back inside your home, you want to make sure you protect your Seestar from scratches, from dust. That's where the inspiration came from, the fact that I actually got a scratch and I left it next to a wall. So why not put a cover on it and protect your Seestar? And these are handmade in-house and custom fit for both, like I said, the S30 and the S50. Get them while you can.
As far as changing your location, do you guys know how to do that? Customize your location on your Seestar. It's super cool. On your homepage, you can literally write whatever you want on there. Like, you know, your location, will, your little city will be there. This, right? You can change that now to whatever you want. I mean, I think it's kind of been like that since the last update, but I'm gonna show you guys how to do that. You can literally put whatever you want in there. You can put Area 51 if you want. Like, whatever thing you wanna save it to, it's really, really cool, okay? Check it out. Click on the plus sign, location information. I basically click on save and you just enter a name, literally whatever name that you want. Like I was saying earlier, I want to put them in Area 51. I want to put them in Las Vegas, whatever I want, right? And then you're going to click on confirm. And you see it right there. It popped up Area 51. And now my location here is Area 51, and you can actually add emojis because you notice I added an emoji here on mine. So pretty cool. Anyway, I thought you had to literally be at that location, but you don't. You can just edit the name field. Your coordinates will stay the same. even as you're searching, you can search stargazing locations. And let's say, will it let me choose like an observatory? Will it even find this? Oh, it did. The Griffith Observatory. Okay, so that's cool. So if I click on this, it's going to move me to that location, right? So here's the observatory in Los Angeles. Okay, so yeah, I mean, there you have it. So that's pretty cool. Then you can save it. This is cool. If I save this, what is it gonna do? Observatory. Confirm. The Seestar still is going to show me that location, even though I'm not technically there. I thought it was gonna like, I don't know why I thought right now it would try to like deviate the scope or something, thinking it's somewhere else all of a sudden, like try to plate solve or something. But anyway. Oh, now it's telling me I can't choose another location unless I stop the image enhancement. Okay, we're gonna pretend we're in Los Angeles then, for now, because I don't want to stop the imaging. But there you go, that's how you can change your location. Just another tip and trick, best objects to see right now, if you're unsure of what's visible. Let's say you can only see, for me it's like, what is that? South, southeast, southwest. North is more difficult for me to see. So you're gonna click on more, little toggle. You're gonna click on that little toggle on the right. And then you have your filter wheel. And I already chose it to what I can see best here, right? So my north is kind of difficult. My south is better. Southeast, southwest. Actually, so it'll switch off. Let me show you guys. Let's say I could only see north. Let's say that's all I can see. You press OK. And then everything that's north pops up. I've checked this with you know, your star maps and stuff. It's correct. It is correct. And you can choose what time you want to try to see these objects at what time, which is kind of cool. And then how high up in the sky. Press OK. And there you go. See, it reset to what I can see right now. Just know that whatever you have on red is what you can see.